Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. Here I have this glass jar which was somehow extra. I didn't use it for the long time, so I decided to use it today for this project. I will be sticking it this glass jar on a plate, steel plate. It's better to use the super glue to stick the jar with the plate instead of hot glue. Then here I have this leg I have made with the foil, and I will be just checking the place where I need to stick it and which will be the exact pose what actually I wanted to create. Then I will be sticking it here with the hot glue, and that's better as well if you use super glue to stick the foil as well with this glass jar, because you know hot glue doesn't work properly. I was facing a little bit problem while sticking it because it was coming out. And later it came in my mind that it was better to use a super glue. So that's a tip for you, do not face the problem as I did. And here I have this air dry clay which I will be using now to cover all the legs and the upper part of the body. With this one I am using the clay only on basic areas where I need to make them prominent. The body parts and like trouser tights she will be wearing, so only on that places I'm using the clay. But the rest of the body, like the jar part, like as you can see, it's like stomach, big fat lady, so that will be covered with the fabric, so you don't need to use the clay on those parts. I was using water to make the clay smooth, and then here I have white fabric which I have dipped into glue and water mixture. The glue is more than water actually. Make sure you are doing the same thing, otherwise your fabric will not be sticky or not be hard. So then I will be wrapping it around her legs to make the leggings for her, or you can say the tights. Same thing for the other leg as well. And the reason to use the fabric, because I am not perfect with the clay to create the wrinkles or trapping for the dress, where are the lines or wrinkles on the dress. So it's better for me to use fabric because it gives nice finishing and nice wrinkles of the dress or anything, tights, trouser, whatever. Then here again I have applied the clay on top of the body part, like where I wanted to create her chest to be prominent, a little bit under the neck area actually. So there I applied the clay, and the rest of the body I am covering again with the same fabric dipped into glue and water. I'm just keep adding the fabric until I get the desired look what was in my mind to create. So I cannot tell exactly how much fabric length or width you need for the fabric. It's just while working you see how much you need it. And then here are the arms also with the foil, which I have covered the front part of the arms and hands with the clay. The rest of the arm is having foil, so because I will be covering that part of the foil as well with the fabric, so you don't need to use the clay on those covered parts. The same thing I'm doing on front, I'm covering from the back side as well. And yeah. After covering the arms from the top with the clay so they stick properly with the other clay on top, here is the same fabric again dipped into white glue and water mixture, which I am wrapping around her arms to make them thick enough, and it will be like she is wearing a scarf over her dress covering her shoulders. And the reason to wrap the fabric first here, this is not the only fabric I will be wrapping, I will be using other thick fabric as well, just to make her body prominent wrapped around the fabric, and fat body lady, something like this. So this is the same thing I'm doing here again with the fabric wrapping her arms to keep the shape in mind and to make them look thick enough. Then here I'm making her chest with clay to make it a little bit wider, because I will be covering this part as well with the fabric, so this should be a little bit prominent instead of having a flat body. Here is the fabric which I have cut it into triangle shape just to make the style for the dress or shirt she is wearing. So same fabric I have dipped into white glue and water mixture. I'm keep saying this because it's not just a plain fabric. I need to get the hard look after getting dry, so you have to dip it into glue, or you can use the cement, that's the best thing. And here I have created some wrinkles and pleats close to her chest area to make it a little bit fat look of her dress. So then here I'm pressing it down under the breast to make it looks prominent, and just to create more wrinkles, because I love to create wrinkles with the fabric on my sculptures. So that's why I prefer to use fabric instead of clay. And the same fabric here, you can see it's same like scarf triangle shape which I'm covering over her shoulders and bringing it into her arms and pressing it inside, so to get the look I actually wanted to have. And then the same thing again, some pieces of fabric dip into the white glue and wrapping it around her arms. It's up to you whatever dress you want to make her wear or whatever outfit you want to make her wear. So that's just my choice which I'm doing now. So that's why I'm using much more fabric to make her look a little bit fatty and happy. Again, some fabric, same one, thick one, I have dipped into glue, and then here I'm putting it under her arms over her legs to create the front part of the dress. Like you can see, she is wearing a shirt and then she is having a skirt under this, but the skirt color, this one what I'm putting now, that's going to be the part of her skirt which I will be covering it, and she's wearing the long shirt as well. Here I have foil on top of wire, and then I'm using the same air dry clay to make her head. No details, nothing, just as it is, just the shape of the face instead of having the face features and those things, because I'm not good at all into making the details of the face, so I'm just leaving it as. This is, you can see, is bandage roll. I took it from pharmacy, and then here I have white glue, same mixture I was using to dip the fabrics. I have added some light brown bricks color acrylic paint into the glue, and then with these bandages I will be making her hair. So first I will be putting the wire over her body, and then I'm using the clay, same clay, to make the neck. This is how I made the neck and head. It's bending a little bit on the side, and then the same bandage I have dipped into the water and glue mixture and the color. these bandages. I'm just putting over her head roughly, like she is having curly messy hair. And yeah, I'll keep adding more bandages until I get the desired look. Here you can see. Then here I'm trying to make the shoes she is wearing. I really appreciate those people who really do the good detailings for the miniatures, small tiny stuffs. I am really not good into these things, but I tried my best to create the looks what I was thinking to make. And this is the shoes I'm trying to make she's wearing. Yeah, it was a little bit difficult for me to create the exact shape I was thinking to make for the shoes, but that's fine, I have done it somehow. And then because this is a steel type plate, it will not be giving any other color, and it was dirty. If it's golden clear one, I would be leaving it as it is. Then I wrapped some tissues over it with the glue to color it later. And then with the black acrylic paint, I'm coloring her trouser, her tights, not trouser actually, or leggings or long socks. Actually, it's not tights. I have been saying it tights, but it's not actually tights. I just realized it what I have been talking. Sorry for that. It's just long socks. And then I'm using the green acrylic paint. It's not exact green, but somehow I don't know what color exactly it is. I was having it, so I tried to use it here for her shirt. And then this is going to be the scarf color, which I'm using dark maroon color, but later on I will be coloring it with the red color more. And this was wrong actually. I should color it all from the back maroon color to make it like a scarf she is wearing on her shoulders. And for the bottom for her skirt, I just highlighted some part of the same dress with the mustard color yellow acrylic paint. And for the body parts which are prominent, like hands, neck and chest, I will be using beige color, skin color acrylic paint. And the same color I'm using over her legs to make them a little bit prominent, like her thighs should be prominent a little bit. And this is, now you can see it's long socks. And then I'm coloring the shoes with that light brown acrylic paint, and the bottom of the shoes all will be with the black acrylic paint, just to highlight and to define the shape of the shoes. And yeah, I was thinking to create some looks, some more detailings in shoes, but I'm not good at it, so I left it as it is. And here you can see with the more darker red color, I started to highlight the scarf separately, and you can see the shapes and the details. I totally love this project. I think it's my first time I have created something like this, and I'm seriously so happy with the end results. Maybe I will be making some more something like this. And then with the white acrylic paint, I'm highlighting and creating some lines on her long socks. And same thing I will be doing for the both sides of the socks. And here you can see how it looks like now. And then I have white acrylic paint, which I'm using on top of the shirt neck area and the front part of the sleeves to create it looks like a lace on her dress. Just plain black acrylic paint, making some dots on top of the gray just to create a design. And then here I have these accessories. It was with the shoes for my son, Wilson shoes, but he didn't use these things for his shoes, so I decided to use them here. And here I have these glasses as well with the same footballs and those things it came. I will be sticking it here on her face to make her look like a funky woman, a happy fat woman. And then here I have this lace fabric. It's not dipped into glue, it's as it is fabric. I'll be using some hot glue on top of her head. Sorry for that actually. it's too hot, and then I stick that fabric on top of her head. And here is the final project. You can see I totally love this one. I am seriously very happy with the end results. Maybe there will be some mistakes, but for me, I found it much better than my other projects, because I tried to create actually some details in it. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, share and subscribe to channel. Encourage me to do more, and may I have a share of my video with your family and friends. That will be great. Thank you so much for your time to watch, and I will see you in the next video.